Good morning. Want to get California today by email? Here's the sign up. Lori's Homes. The landscape in San Francisco. California's housing costs are among the highest in the country. Jim Wilson, New York Times. Is the Golden State really a progressive utopia? Hardly. According to new research from the Advancement Project California, a Los Angeles-based civil rights group, in studying seven key quality of life issues: crime and justice, democracy, economic opportunity, education, healthy built environment, healthcare access, and housing, researchers found significant markers of disparity in counties throughout the state. The project maps out each issue for all of the state's 58 counties and breaks each result down to the county level. John Kim, the executive director of Advancement Project California, said the numbers prove just how much further the state has to go to help foster equality. We have some areas, like housing and economic development, which are actually pretty good in terms of equality, Mr. Kim said. But these are problems throughout the state where you can really see how pronounced of a factor race is. Overall, and perhaps not surprisingly, the Bay Area is home to some of the most stubborn and dramatic gaps. Both because of the tech boom and because of the history of segregation there, we have it calcified, Mr. Kim said. It really gives lie to the notion that a rising tide will lift all boats. California Online. Please note we regularly highlight articles on news sites that have limited access for non-subscribers. Gov. Jerry Brown of California last week. Mr. Brown on Wednesday pardoned Craig R. Coley, a man who spent nearly 40 years behind bars for a murder the authorities say he did not commit. Philip Galland, European Press. Photo agency Gov. Jerry Brown pardoned a man who was in prison for nearly four decades after a new investigation proved he had been wrongly convicted. The New York Times. Covina police officers shot a man who had barricaded himself and his seven-month-old daughter in his car for several hours. The Los Angeles Times. Nearly 70% of voters in Marin County voted in favor of recreational marijuana. But county officials have rejected all 10 applications to open medical marijuana dispensaries. San Francisco Chronicle. Adela Morales and Adrian Bonilla with their grandchildren, who lived in an RV community in East Palo Alto, California, until they were evicted last week. Jason Henry for the New York Times. Is Facebook making it harder and more expensive to rent in East Palo Alto? One family says it is driving its landlord to evict them. The New York Times. How will Inglewood, a longtime bastion for the black middle class, change as more white people move in? The Los Angeles Times. He helped elect George W. Bush. Now this Republican political consultant is working to elect a Democrat for the governor's seat. Car matters. The Orange County Congressman Dana Rohrabacher's long-standing ties to Russia are coming under renewed criticism and scrutiny. The New York Times. Jennifer Gamble gathering her store flyers before the family heads out for Thanksgiving dinner at King's Hawaiian Bakery restaurant. Carlos Gonzalez for the New York Times. They have shopped every Black Friday for nearly two decades. A glimpse of the spree edition. The New York Times. This Malibu church is no longer serving two meals a day for the homeless, after critics suggested it was helping to attract the homeless to the area. The Los Angeles Times. Are churches that cater to Asian Americans in Orange County changing their attitudes about same relationships? The Orange County Register. Coming up this week, looking for the perfect Christmas tree? Try the Tulare Christmas Tree Auction, which opens Tuesday with profits going to local charities. Tour homes while sipping tea and raising money for Valley Children's Hospital in Fresno at the annual La Comida Guild Home Tour. Men Alive, Orange County Gay Men's Chorus, opens Friday with Santa Sun at Irving Barclay Theatre on. Finally, for decades, the corner of North Shoreline and Space Parkway in the North Bayshore section of Mountain View was a sleepy area with an aging gym, a dive bar, and several office buildings. Today, however, it has become a case study in the Bay Area's booming tech industry and escalating housing crisis. Recreational vehicles line the area's side streets. A nearby trailer park has filled up with tech employees, some of whom have Teslas parked in front of their modest mobile homes. David Boyer, a 46-year-old radio producer who lives in San Francisco, profiled the Mountain View area in his podcast, The Intersection. The intersection, which looks at neighborhood change through the lens of a street corner, had three previous installments that focused on the Bayview, Tenderloin and Haight-Ashbury neighborhoods of San Francisco. This time, Mr. Boyer said, he wanted to look at Silicon Valley, and found the juxtaposition of a trailer park and Google, which owns most of the land and office space in North Bayshore, to be an intriguing mix. Mr. Boyer spent a year interviewing residents and businesses in the area. The podcast has six episodes that run about a half hour each. They begin with the Silicon Valley's agricultural past and progress through the growth of the tech industry to today's questions about homelessness and how Mountain View is looking to transform its various office parks into a bustling urban neighborhood centered on Google. The podcast features mobile home residents, local business owners, Mountain View's mayor and people who live in their cars. And while the voices of several Googlers can be heard, one group you will not hear from is the company's corporate officers. California Today goes live at 6 a.m. Pacific Time weekdays. Tell us what you want to see Saturday at nighttimes.com. California Today is edited by Julie Bloom, who grew up in Los Angeles and graduated from UC Berkeley.